Hello and welcome to another Magic the Gathering unboxing. So anybody that's watched the channel for quite a while now will know that I've not really been unboxing NA intro packs for a long while. I think the last time I did it was around the Return to Ravnica block. So when Return to Ravnica came out, and I suppose as a result of various comments from viewers and friends of the channel, I made a commitment to basically unbox all of the intro packs of that block. So that would be 15 decks. And the problem was, by the end of it, I felt like I was done with intro packs. So from that point going forward, I decided that I wouldn't open any more intro packs. However, I do acknowledge that intro packs now have morphed into something called Planeswalker decks, and although I skipped over the Kaladesh set in terms of opening them, because that was the first set they appeared, I was looking recently at the deck lists for the Aether Revolt Planeswalker decks, and I thought they looked pretty interesting. So I thought this might be a good time to actually examine the Planeswalker decks and talk a bit in depth about what's in there, and various synergies, and maybe speculate on where, Wizards might be going forward, because there's a lot of relationship between obviously what's in here and the synergies in a set, and what having just two Planeswalker decks. So there's actually two in this set, as there was in the previous set, Ajani and Tezzeret. But what the inclusion of just two intro decks, what implication that has, with, I suppose, intro packs and Planeswalker decks, theme decks, whatever you want to call them, as the museum piece. Wonderful word that I picked up off a Gathering Magic article, and I very much think of intro packs, theme decks, Planeswalker decks as museum piece decks. They sort of represent a particular period in Magic's history. Which is, if you want to explore a particular set, it's always interesting, if you're not familiar with it, to start off with the relevant theme deck from that set or intro pack, whatever it was called at that point, and sort of work out. I do accept that often they include some very weird cards in these that seem really out of place, but generally they sort of orientate you and you get a feel for the themes that were going on and some of the keywords and abilities that were in the set. So what we're going to do is crack these open. I'm going to do obviously two separate videos for this. I might spend a bit more time on this first one conceptually, because it's just interesting to look at, how the cards in here, where they come from, how they fit in the set, that sort of thing. And so it's particularly aimed at people that have probably never opened or never seen one of these Planeswalker decks and is curious. Maybe they've seen them on the shelf and they just want to know what's inside of them. So I do like the new packaging on these. According to the back of this, this particular deck, which is a Ajani Valiant Protector. So they tend to have, oh, actually they've both got take back the power on them as a sort of tagline. So I think the backs of these are, yeah, they are different. So on the Ajani one, it says, "Get started playing Magic right away. Unite the rogue inventors of Kaladesh to build up an unstoppable force of renegades ready to stand against corruption and retake the capital. Join forces with the mighty Planeswalker Ajani Goldmane with a card unique to this deck to claim your victory." So when these decks first, were spoiled, and I'm talking about the original concept of the Planeswalker deck, people very much saw these, with the lead, each one having a lead Planeswalker, as maybe these would be like a powered down version of the main, if you like, the main Planeswalker in the set. And certainly that is a way they've been perceived. But what's interesting with these decks is they're very synergistic. And so that's sort of raised the the spectre again of what if Wizards were to create a Planeswalker for the Planeswalker deck that, although appeared to be a powered down version, because of its synergistic with either the deck or the wider card pool in Magic, actually was a stronger or just a more in demand Planeswalker. And maybe this is going to be a thing with those decks. Certainly what's interesting, and unfortunately I hadn't looked at the Kaladesh prices, but the card prices for the, like, if you like, the full power Planeswalker in the set, as opposed to the other Planeswalker, the sort of cut back Planeswalker in the subset, they're in the same sort of ballpark figure. And in the, all of these cards are in the more expensive side of the set. If you were to list the set price wise top to bottom on, say, MTG Goldfish, you would find that the both of these Planeswalkers are in that top 10, if you like, I think, of the expensive cards, if not top 10, still very close to that. So let's open these up. There's some boosters in here, so it's going to be interesting. What I'm going to do, actually, once I've just opened this, I'm going to reference back to the player's guide, because there's something, again, if you're not familiar with this, I need to reference back. It looks like we have quite a large deck box in here, which looks like it may well take sleeved cards in it. It might be wide enough to do that. It actually doesn't mention, I think, anything about deck boxes on the outside. Well, there you go. I'm just trying to think if it's wide enough there to fit the whole deck fully sleeved. But anyway, that's just a bonus. These have all been already assembled. It's quite a nice deck box there, even though it is obviously cardboard. We have our what I would call our deck guide. Let's just open this up. So, pretty much standard format with this sort of deck guide stuff. You've got a backstory thing, so that's part of obviously the Magic story. Obviously, stuff they're also trying to sell. And then over here, a little bit about playing the deck. There we go. How to boost the deck. So broad concepts here. I mean, if you remember in the original intro packs, they often would make card suggestions. And here they're sort of making, I would say, broad suggestions, where they're saying don't swap cards into the deck from your booster packs until you know how the deck plays and are ready to upgrade. Once you know the deck, open your boosters and look for more artifact green and white cards that have revolt abilities or that let you take advantage of other cards' revolt abilities. If you open any exciting rares or mythic rares that match the deck's colours, feel free to swap those in too. Okay, so very broad advice. Okay, here. So the other interesting thing is I don't think they've marked up what I would call the special cards of the deck. So just to explain that, as this is the first one I'm opening on camera, if I dig out the player's guide that comes with the fat pack, this is what you get if you buy a fat pack, they always have these in them. Towards the back of the card encyclopedia, they have a listing of cards which don't actually appear in booster packs. Their numbers are higher than 185 because all the cards have a card number on them. And these are the ones that actually appear in the Planeswalker decks. So you can see they're listed with the Ajani relevant Planeswalker deck cards first, and then the Tezzeret ones. And what you will normally find is in this list is that sort of, and again, I'll just use the term loosely here, the sort of powered down Planeswalker. You will then probably find something that is synergistic with the one of the themes in the deck, because often the deck will have a couple of themes that overlap. And even better if those themes that overlap synergistically in quite a high degree. And then what you also find is there will be a card that tutors for the lead planeswalker. Obviously pretty important when you've got a deck where there's only one copy of your lead card. Over consecutive games, there's a good chance that if you only have a single copy, you may never see the card. Whereas if you've got tutoring going on, then that's more likely to happen. Then there's probably a card in there that cares about your card in some way, and you can see, I don't know how clear that is. We'll see a Jani's Aid, but it actually names specifically the Planeswalker card. And then also they've got a card here, a non-basic land, which fixes for green white, albeit does enter the battlefield tapped. And you can see they've basically done a similar thing here with the cards from the Tezzeret deck. So a couple of boosters, which we'll open in a moment, see what we can crack open. But let's actually have a look at this main deck also. We haven't done is pull out this. So this is our lead Planeswalker, which is also foil, as you can clearly see. If anybody wonders, the playmat here is actually the most recent when I bought it, of the Star City Games creature collection. It's the Corgi Firewalker. Okay, so we'll start off with Jani, Valiant Protector, which is 4 colorless green white for a 4 loyalty planeswalker. So +2, put 2/1/1 counters on up to 1 target creature. +1, reveal cards from the top of your library until you reveal a creature card. Put that card into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. And then the -11, well, that's a pretty extreme ultimate. It's going to be interesting to see if we've got any cards in the deck that sort of mess with loyalty counters. But anyway, -11, put X +1/+1 counters on target creature, where X is your life total. That creature gains trample and until end of turn. Now, within this deck, you're going to see a couple of themes, main themes coming to the fore here. We've got the presence of +1/+1 counters on here. And also the particular mechanic here, which is would be the revolt mechanic. Okay, but also I've noticed that both decks seemingly care about life in some way, so that's something else to sort of consider. And this is a green white deck. There's a lot of cards in Magic's history in white that care about life. The other decks, blue-black, there's a lot of cards in Magic's history in black that, through the mechanism of life gain and the exchange of life and using life as a resource. So black very much cares about life as well. Anyway, so we've got Solemn Recruit in the deck. I'll go through all the rares specifically in detail, and anything that's obviously got revolt in it, which is relevant, or +1/+1 counters. 1/2 white for a 2/2 creature dwarf wizard with double strike. It has revolt in it. At the beginning of your end step, if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn, put a +1/+1 counter on Solemn Recruit. Ajani's Aid. So this is a card that cares about the presence of Ajani. So two green white. I keep saying two colorless. What I really mean to say is two generic mana. Two generic mana, green white enchantment. When a Ajani's aid enters the battlefield, you may search your library and or graveyard for a card named Ajani Valiant Protector. Reveal it and put it into your hand. If you search your library this way, shuffle it. Sacrifice Ajani's aid, prevent all combat damage a creature of your choice would deal this turn. So there we've got our tutoring, and not surprisingly, there's a couple of those. You'll find with a lot of these pre-cons, you tend to get like twos of things. They don't often go for the full-blown four ofs, except in the case of that non-blade basic land. There may be the odd card, but it, you know, it's like twos and ones and threes and stuff like that. You don't get an awful lot of, you know, four of this, four of that, four of something else. So they're not making it super tuned. So the idea here again is to play with variants, get you, you know, experiencing what it's like to have different cards interacting with one another, but also not shooting themselves in the foot financially by giving you a fully tuned, powerful deck to start with. So, you know, they want you to go out and basically crack boosters, or basically want you to crack boosters because they don't make any money off of you buying singles. But anyway, that's another story. So moving on, Aid from the Cowl, three green. It's got its enchantment. It's got Revolt on it. At the beginning of your end step, if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn, reveal the top card of your library. If it's a permanent card, you may put it onto the battlefield. Otherwise, you may put it on the bottom of your library. Narnam Renegade is a single green elf warrior with Death Touch and Revolt on it. So when it enters the battlefield, it comes with a +1/+1 counter on it if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn. And there's a couple of those. We got Verdant Automaton in here. Cares about +1/+1 counters. And a couple of those. Ajani's Comrade. So one and a green for 2/2 with Trample. At the beginning of combat on your turn, if you control an Ajani Planeswalker, put a +1/+1 counter on Ajani's Comrade. So that obviously cares about Ajani. And there's actually three of those. Audacious Infiltrator, one and a white for a 3/1 Dwarf Rogue, and three of those. Ghirapur's Guide, one of those. Silk Weaver Elite has Reach and Revolt on it. So with Revolt, obviously caring about when this card enters the battlefield, the card with Revolt on it, if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn. So a couple of those. Deadeye Harpooner, another card with Revolt on it. Armorcraft Judge, cares about +1/+1 counters. And two of those. Lifecraft Cavalry cares about both has Revolt on it, and as part of that Revolt, it cares about counters. You can see when it enters a battlefield, does so with 2+1/+1 counters on it if a permanent you controlled left the battlefield this turn. Two of those. Ridge Scale Tusker, an ETB with a +1/+1 counter. An ETB with the ability to put +1/+1 counters on each other creature you control. Airdrop Aeronauts has Revolt on it. Renegade Map. So this is an artifact where enters the battlefield tapped. You can sacrifice it, tap it, sacrifice it. And you search your library for a basic land card, reveal it, put it into your hand, then shuffle your library. So that's going to hunt down your basic land. So we've got three of those for fixing our mana. Got Preyupon in here. So this is a sort of green removal, if you like, through fighting. Unbridled Growth. This is an enchantment that helps you to sort your mana out. So you can enchant a land and add one mana of any colour to your mana pool. A couple of those. Natural Obsolescence. Basically buries a, well, actually buries the wrong word, but it tucks a target artifact on the bottom of an owner's library. Daredevil Dragster. Another artifact, the vehicle. Uses velocity counters. Inspiring Roar. Put a +1/+1 counter on each creature you control. And I think there's a full complement of these. So there's actually four of these. I think this is the only four of in the deck. Engineered Might, 3 green white sorcery. Modal spell there. And then, well, actually there is another four of, and that's the non-basic lands. So these enter the battlefield tapped, and they tap for green or white mana, and there is actually four of those. And then we have our mana base here, which are all artwork from the Kaladesh set. All feature there. Quickly go through that if you've not seen the artwork yet for this. So there we have the deck. So you can see there, obviously, cards either having revolt triggers on them, caring about +1/+1, or a bit of both. But not all cards were definitely overlapping with the two themes in the deck on there. So what we'll do, we'll open up our boosters, see if we've got anything interesting in here. Obviously, we're looking for green or white stuff that's going to synergize well with the deck. So we've got Decommission in here. So that for 2 and a white will destroy a target artifact or enchantment. It's also got Revolt on it. Aether Chaser. Leave in the Dust. Conviction, so another white card. It's a 1 and a white enchant creature. Enchanted creature gets +1/+3. For white in return, Conviction to its owner's hand. I've always found these bounceable enchantments very interesting. You know, because normally if you attach an enchantment to a creature and the creature gets removed, the enchantment also ends up in the graveyard. It's not like equipment where it sort of sits there and you can reattach it. But throughout Magic's history, there's been several enchantment cards which allow you to recover that enchantment in some way, either by, in this case, you'd often have to have one a single white mana free to do that, but there are other cards in Magic's history which will bounce back to your hand, like enchantments will bounce back. Night Market Aeronaut, it's got Revolt on it, so Revolt was in black as well. Aether Herder, that cares about energy, so more at home in a energy deck, and along you can see it's caring about servo artifact creatures as well. Aether Inspector, another card that deals with energy. Implement of Malice, this has a black activation cost on it, so not really at home in this deck. Reservoir Walker, another card that cares about energy and also life. Filigree Crawler, as well, when it dies it creates a Thopter artifact creature token. It is itself an artifact creature insect. Lifecrafter's Gift, so we've got a green one here. So put a +1/+1 counter on a target creature, then put a +1/+1 counter on each creature you control with a +1/+1 counter on it. So this is interesting. This is a green, I think it's Proliferate. So Proliferate was a mechanic from the Scars and Mirrodin block. So it's interesting to see this in green. This would be useful in the deck. Servo Schematic, Vengeful Rebel, so another black card with Revolt on it. Shram's Expertise, so this is a rare, it's 2 and 2 white, but it cares more about servo artifact creature tokens, so it'll create 3/1/1 colourless servo artifact creature tokens. You may cast a card with converted mana cost 3 or less from your hand without paying its mana cost. And we have a forest and an energy reserve for our energy cards. So, you know, looking back through that, there's a couple of white card, a green card and a white card here. That, you know, wouldn't be out of place in the deck, whether or not they would be worthy of replacing something else in the deck is something that you have to obviously consider when you're looking to replace cards in there. But you often find with intro products and intro level pre-cons, there are sometimes, you know, more often than not, what I would think are dead cards in there that aren't particularly powerful. So second pack here, we've got Precise Strike, single red instant, Aether Swooper, Alley Invasion, single white. So we'll look at this. So this is basically a combat trick. It's modal, so target creature you control gets +1/+2 until end of turn. Return target creature you control to its owner's hand. You can choose one of those. Aether Chaser, High Spire Infusion, another green card that cares about energy. And it's also another combat trick. Cruel Finality, basically removal for anything of 2/2 or less. Scrying it as well. Implement of Ferocity, it's artifact with green activation cost. So this will, if you sacrifice it, put a +1/+1 counter on target creature, activate this ability. When Implement of Ferocity is put into a graveyard from battlefield, draw a card. So I don't think the deck in this particular deck cares much about artifacts, although it's a, you're putting a +1/+1 counter on this if you sacrifice it. Beyond that, there's no additional synergy, I don't think. I mean, you've got the card draw, but Reservoir Walker cares about energy. Implement of Malice, it's got a black activation cost on it. Ironclad Revolutionary, so we're moving on to our uncommons here. This is interesting, this is not on colour in our deck, but you'll see it actually cares about cares about counters and also life. It says, when Ironclad Revolution enters the battlefield, you may sacrifice an artifact. If you do, put +2/+1/+1 counters on Ironclad Revolution, and each opponent loses 2 life. So there's 3 things going on here, really. It's caring about artifacts. You've got artifacts sort of sack, and then you've got the counters, and you've got the life. Daredevil Dragster, Consulate Dreadnought, 7/11 with crew 6 for 1. And our rare is off colour, and it's Piers Revolution. So it's 2 and a red enchantment. Whenever a non-token artifact is put into your graveyard from the battlefield, return that card to your hand unless target opponent has Piers Revolution deal 3 damage to him or her. And we've got a nice foil forest there. And mountain and an Ethereum cell. So this token here, there I did see a card earlier actually which produces this, and I just can't remember where I saw it. But basically there's a card that specifically produces Ethereum cells. You attack it, sacrifice this artifact, add 1 mana of any color to your mana pool. There may even be that card in the Tesseract deck. Anyway, we'll know when we unbox it, basically, whether that's the case. So anyway, there we have it. A couple of boosters. You know, there was probably more cards in the first pack there that were more relevant to what we were trying to achieve in this deck. But anyway, I hope you get a good idea about the Ajani Valiant Protector deck here. So this is one of the two new Planeswalker decks in Aether Revolt. So bye for now. Thanks for watching.